You and she have joined hands.
Let's don't say anything to spoil it. It's so nice like this. It's so nice to have a friend. And she came right to me.
Well, the others will come to you.
Now the others are right here, and they will come to you also. Here's Marcia, dear. Come, girls. Clara, Helen, Margie. And this is Vanessa, who kept your music for you. Sid, Mike, hop out, boys. Nancy kept waiting for the end of the world. And she's the one who dreaded Armageddon. And Mary. The memory of Grandma. Sybil Ann, don't be shy, sweetie. Here's Sybil. Come on, Peggy.
I'm afraid to meet Peggy right now.
She's afraid of scaring you.
She didn't mean to break the windows. She got it confused with something else. With getting out of the kitchen.
How do you know that? She's speaking to you, isn't she?
Where is she? Is she there?
Of course. Peggy? Peggy? Peggy, don't be silly.
I don't think I'm ready yet. Dr. Wilbur?
It's all right, sweetie. I'm still here.
Is that all she is? Just that little thing?
I'm not a little thing. I'm a person.
I'm sorry. You don't be afraid of me, and I won't be afraid of you. What have you got behind your back, Peggy? Haven't you got any hands?
I got fists.
Oh, my. Look at those knuckles. They're so white.
In accepting Peggy into her arms, Sybil began the deepest healing of herself. In embracing Peggy, she embraced herself. In calming her, she was calming her own heart. As I watched her becoming mother to herself, I felt my own long motherhood ending. I released what I had held so long. I celebrated the beginning of her emancipation. I let go. Our work together lasted 11 years. Today, Sybil lives peacefully in a small college town where she's a professor of art. There's not enough time in the day for her to do everything she wants. But that time, in every sense, is her own. She tells me she's happy. I know she's free.